But what's that? Mr. Owaisi, how can you be so hypocritical? A question to you.
And one more thing. I would like to ask to Mr. Owaisi. Indonesia is the biggest Muslim country in the world.
And the national carrier of Indonesia is called Garuda Airways.
Garuda Airways was considered the vehicle of God Vishnu. If Indonesia can accept their culture as a culture, not interfering in the religion, so why is not accepting here in India?
Cultures,
all the cultural icons that term it as anti-Islamic. Why it is so?
You know, can I please come into this conversation, please? Mr. Gaurav Bhatia, 1 minute. Gaurav Bhatia, Asaduddin Owaisi, in an interview to another channel, at one point of time said, there is no other country where there are so many religions. There is no other country.
Yes, I told you.
Let me complete. Let me complete. Because you know you are about to be completely exposed. Don't stop me.
I still stand.
Don't stop me because you are going to completely reveal your malafide intentions.
Allows me to practice my faith.
Mr. Owaisi, I am just about to reveal your hypocrisy.
Which is part of Article 19.
Mr. Owaisi, I told you not to teach me the law. I told you not to teach me the law. If you teach me the law, Mr. Owaisi.
Frankly speaking, interview other places which I have given.
Mr. Owaisi, if you teach me the law, I will prove to your hypocrisy and please have the courage to listen.
I am not teaching you the law.
Please have the courage to listen.
I am uneducated over here. You are an expert in law. You are jack of all trades. I am master of none.
Mr. Owaisi, now he listen to me.
You are jack of all trades. I am master of none.
Fine.
Go ahead. Please.
Now, Mr. Owaisi, listen to me. You see, sometimes I feel that when I'm just about to reveal the reason for your hypocrisy, I don't like calling anyone a hypocrite politically or otherwise.
No.
But if somebody is being a political hypocrite, I've got to make my point clearly to the person.
And all these things, you know, I can counter.
But Mr. Owaisi, hear me.
Don't do it.
Mr. Owaisi.
Ask me a pointed question. I will give you a pointed reply.
Yeah, so have the courage to listen to the question.
Questions, and you're looking towards BJP or Samajwadi Party, take me on. For the first time, the anchor Arnab Goswami is lost for questions.
Mr. Owaisi, now if you have the courage to listen to the question, then I will very much appreciate it. But it appears to me, Mr. Owaisi.
And that is why I'm saying.
Okay, so here are four questions for you, Mr. Owaisi. I'll tell you. Now, since here are four questions for you. And you know what? You want to go to a wishy-washy, namby-pamby channel that asks you underhand deliveries. You won't get away with this on Times Now. Mr. Owaisi, you had said that you praise India's pluralism and diversity. You had even said, and you can't go back on it now, you said pluralism. Let me complete. Again, you're interrupting me. You said pluralism is India's soul. Did someone force you to say that?
I've learned this habit from you.
And by ascribing a superiority to Islam over all religions, by claiming that all non-Muslims are converts and that Islam is the real
part of my faith.
That Islam is the real home to all religions. You have proven your hypocrisy.
I will never say that. No.
And secondly, Mr. Owaisi,
wrong interpretation.
Secondly, Mr. Owaisi, if Praveen Togadia is your idol. Now, I can't help it, but it appears to me he is.
Praveen Togadia appears to be your idol. Ambedkar is my idol.
Praveen Togadia appears to be your idol. You seem to idolize Praveen Togadia, Mr. Owaisi.
Is my ideal.
I'll tell you why you seem to be the equivalent of Praveen Togadia. Don't mind it. I'll ask you straight.
You said make your straight points. I am not.
Okay, so 3 points to you.
I am not a cancer doctor and I am not a cancer to this nation.
Mr. Owaisi.
I am saying that Mr. Owaisi, the cancer cannot be connected to the nationalism of
the country. There is nothing more dangerous or worrying than the cancer of religious polarization. Okay, so I certainly think that you need to act against. I'll give you 3 reasons. Let's talk straight today, Mr. Owaisi. 3 reasons why I feel you are idolizing Praveen Togadia.
Right into your eyes.
Mr. Owaisi, listen to me. You want to listen
because
to 3 reasons?
I wanted to come. I have come.
Are you worried about listening to 3 reasons? 3 reasons why you and Praveen Togadia are mirror images of each other.
Why only three? Just three.
Enough to silence you. Three. One, you are speaking the same language of Praveen Togadia, although you may not be resorting to the same means as them. Point number one.
Only death can silence Asaduddin Owaisi.
Point number two, I don't want an emotional argument, I want a factual one.
He cannot silence me.
Secondly, you are further vitiating an already polarized atmosphere. And thirdly, your claims...
Am I responsible for BJP getting 280 seats?
your claims.
Am I responsible for that ghar wab?
You go back and read. Go back. Go back and read your. Go back and read your party website.
Am I responsible for all the things that are happening in the nation?
You.
I am a single MP.
Go back and read your party website. And after this, Sudhanshu Trivedi can come back on the debate that he wants. One second, Mr. Owaisi.
What is wrong with you,
Mr. Owaisi? What is wrong with you? What is so completely wrong with you that your website says about your party that you are an adherent to the Indian Constitution?
My faith. You have all the right to disagree.
Mr. Owaisi.
I respect people following other religions.
Mr. Owaisi.
That is their fundamental right.
Mr. Owaisi, now please.
And my fundamental right.
Mr. Owaisi, this is not.
And 25.
Mr. Owaisi, on 10th October 2014, you said to the Indian Express, Mohan Bhagwat says the identity of India is Hinduism. Listen to this. Let me completely today, you know, reveal your real intentions. Let me reveal your real intentions.
Islam
again, you are running scared.
Country.
Again, you are scared.
Answer my question.
Again, you are scared to listen.
My question to the anchor is, am I connecting Islam to nationalism of this country?
No. Have you? Will you have the courage to listen?
Nationalism to India's nationalism.
Ladies and gentlemen, I thought by this time.
He believes in bunch of thoughts.
Ladies and gentlemen, and those watching the news are, I want to say something to our viewers.
Internal threat.
Mr. Owaisi,
I am not connecting my religion nationalism to the country.
Mr. Owaisi.
I have not do it.
No, Mr. Owaisi.
I am not saying
now I'll completely.
Only Islam.
Now I'll completely reveal your.
I am not saying Islam.
No. So far, Mr. Owaisi, relax. Relax.
Deliberately, you are trying to pull over the debate.
No, Mr. Owaisi. No, for the first time today, I'm not trying to pull any wool over anyone's eyes, but for the first time today, Mr. Trivedi, I'm coming to you. And Mr. Owaisi, please just listen for a minute. For the first time today, you are being completely exposed. The first time, and it's happening on television.
No, I'm not.
Now you listen to me. Again, you are stopping. First, now you were backtracting. Then you were not being able to answer. But now I'll completely reveal your intentions.
That Mr. Arnab Goswami is looking for questions from panelists.
Mr. Asaduddin Owaisi, I want you to listen for a minute, please.
Answer each and every question.
Mr. Owaisi, why are you looking so shaky even before I ask the question? I'm making a point, and you must let me complete a point. You don't, even if you're shaky, don't appear to be shaky. Here's the question. Now listen to me. On 10th October 2014, Asaduddin Owaisi told the Indian Express, and if he has not said it, let him say I didn't say it. He said, quote, Mohan Bhagwat says, the identity of India is Hinduism, comma, Modi tweets that Bhagwat was correct, full stop. If I had tweeted that Indian identity is Islam, what would have happened? This is what he said.
I am not saying that.
Mr. Owaisi, you have done exactly that. It doesn't matter what you said. You have done exactly that.
This is the only country.
This you have done exactly that.
Earth which celebrates religion. India.
What kind of celebration of religion is this?
India as a nation has no religion. And when we celebrate religion, Mr. Goswami, I have the right to practice my faith.
Nobody's stopping you from that, but you can't say every Indian is born a Muslim. One second, Sudhanshu Trivedi is responding. Sudhanshu Trivedi, this is not a matter of the right to practice religion.
You've not given me a chance to.
No, I'm coming to you, Gaurav Bhatia, but I'm letting Sudhanshu Trivedi respond. He's been waiting for a little longer, please. One second. Yes, Mr. Trivedi.
In this aspect, I would like to urge the entire intellectual and political establishment of India that please refrain from this debate. Hinduism is not a religion by any parameter. No single book, no single god, no single process of worship, nothing which can be termed to Hinduism as a religion. So it cannot be compared with Islam and other or Christianity or whatever it is. Third thing, whatever Praveen Togadia has said is not approvable. But you cannot compare MIM with Praveen Togadia. Akbaruddin Owaisi has said such an dastardly words against any religion which none of the Vishnu Hindu Parishad leader has said to anybody. Third thing, I would like to ask Mr. Owaisi. I am not a very learned man of Islamic matters, but to the best of my knowledge, there are 72 sects of Islam, and India is the only country in the world in which all the 72 sects are there. It is the pluralistic character of India which is in your opinion, if you consider it as a religion, is a Hindu majority state.
Yeah, yeah, of course.
You name a single Muslim state in the world in which all these sects are there. Third thing, if you go by the political parameters, again, I am trying to re-emphasize, these type of tactics are being done successfully in the previous decades by several parties. So he is strictly going by the same principle to create a polarized atmosphere. Then you will see after a certain time, certain parties will approach MIM and they will have a secular debate and communal and secular debate and they will say that, oh, I want to save this country from the communal forces, then I want to come in.
Sure, sure. But then,
okay,
Asaduddin Owaisi responding after that to you, Gaurav, for the final word.
Are you saying that because the 72 sects which are living in India, you are doing a great favor to them? Do you feel that you are the Patwari or Chaudhary of India? Are you saying that, why are you patronizing the Muslims? Are you saying that we are living over here because of your
Mr. Owaisi, it is not only the Islam.
No,
we are living over here. Church of the world is in India, not in Europe.
Years Muslim ruled in India, but look at the population. There was no forcible conversion.
The only
we are living over here.
Mr. Owaisi, are you the ठेकेदार और द पटवारी ऑफ इंडिया? आर यू द ठेकेदार और द पटवारी ऑफ इंडिया दैट यू बिलीव इन द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ अ मुस्लिम घर वापसी?
आई एम एन सर्वेंट, आई एम एन हम्बल.
देन हाउ डू यू बिलीव इन द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ अ रिलीजियस होमकमिंग?
आई एम अ खलंदर.
देन हाउ डू यू बिलीव इन द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ अ रिलीजियस होमकमिंग?
आई एम नॉट अ चौधरी, आई एम नॉट अ पटवारी.
देन व्हाई शुड
आई एम अ खलंदर, आई एम अ सर्वेंट.
व्हाई शुड
दिस इज हाउ आई वांट टू गो फ्रॉम दिस वर्ल्ड?
वेल मिस्टर ओवैसी,
आई विल नेवर बी अ चौधरी, पटवारी, लीडर. नो
मिस्टर ओवैसी,
नथिंग टू डू. असदुद्दीन ओवैसी कैन नॉट.
मिस्टर ओवैसी, यू नो, यू रियली टुडे ऑन दिस डिबेट आई रियली फील दैट यू आर बिगिनिंग टू लूज द स्ट्रेन ऑफ योर ओन argument, because if the people of the Sangh Parivar believe in real homecoming, and we are not talking about reconversions through inducements here,
would
only happen if Muslims or Christians were converted to Hinduism. How are you any different?
Your timing is a bit rusty now.
How are you any different, Mr. Owaisi?
You get your timing right.
Mr. Owaisi, the fact of the...
You are like a great star batsman.
Mr. Owaisi,
is missing the swing of the ball.
Mr. Owaisi, you know what? You're not even reading the ball out here. And you are not even reading the ball out here.
Goswami,
and you don't even understand the questions.
And you have come back after 3-4 days.
Well, you, so Mr. Owaisi, right. You are like,
I'm
the...
I'm sure by next one or two days, you'll get your timing right.
Mr. Owaisi, let's remain restricted to the subject. It appears you want to run away from the subject, but I won't let you get away so quickly. One second, Gaurav.
I'm not running away. I'm sitting in front of you.
Well, you appears you want to duck the question. So then answer the question, Mr. Owaisi. Because every time I ask a question, you seem to speak over it. This is done only by those people who are afraid of asking. Mr. Owaisi,
9 hours I've been traveling
Mr. Owaisi,
from my car I jump into the chair in front of you.
Yes,
how do you say I'm running away?
So, Mr. Owaisi,
Mr. Goswami,
then listen to
debating.
Me, Mr. Owaisi. Listen.
I love debating. Please debate.
Sure, you do. So, you do. Then if you love debating, you understand one thing. You must listen to the question. Only those people who are afraid of listening to the question are usually the people who have no answer to the question.
I am not afraid.
See,
I am
every
only
time,
afraid
I'll
of
prove,
Allah.
I'll prove it.
That's
every
it.
Time I ask
I
you a question, you will...
Any questions,
Mr. Owaisi,
any RSS,
every time...
Any Samajwadi Party,
Mr. Owaisi...
No. Mr. I only fear Allah and the truth will prevail. Please ask me questions.
Mr. Owaisi,
how many questions do you want me to answer? You know, on this program,
this is not
the maximum time I've answered all the questions.
This is not
by Mr. Gaurav or by his daughter.
Again, you are going on. Now, please listen. The problem is, again, you are revealing your nervousness. One second. This is not an All India Majlis-e-Ittihad Muslimin political rally. One second, Gaurav Bhatia.
It is Arnab Goswami's program, and that is why after traveling for 9 hours in a car, I'm sitting in front of you.
Very good. So, Mr. Owaisi, then listen to the question, for God's sake. Don't appear so shaky. The fact of the matter remains, and here's the question, Mr. Owaisi.
No, I'm not shaken.
Now, again,
I'm enjoying
it. Again, you are like looking
this is
so...
What a parliamentarian should do.
Mr. Owaisi, you
Mr.
are looking
Goswami
so unsure that
me.
You are... Mr. Owaisi, first of all, please tell me, the fact of the matter remains, Mr. Owaisi, that you too, like the fringe of the Sangh Parivar, believe in the concept of a homecoming. I am telling you, ask any rational, intelligent, progressive Indian, they will tell you the concept of a religious homecoming is wrong. One second. The very fact that you believe in the concept of a Muslim ghar wapsi shows your inherent disrespect for other faiths.
You are suffering from Islamophobia.
Mr. Owaisi, again, you are not listening.
Profile Islamophobia. I am saying this is my faith. You have all the right to disagree.
Mr.
Owaisi,
did you say? Did you say?
19 and 25 give me the right to practice my faith,
Mr.
to propagate
Owaisi,
my faith.
Mr. Owaisi, you claim to be a party. You claim to be a party.
India has 4,600 communities.
Mr. Owaisi, this is not a lecture.
Who have different faiths.
Mr. Answer the question.
Who have different cultures.
Mr. Owaisi,
are you going to say no? Only the Mr. Arnab Goswami's faith should have prevalence understanding
Mr.
of what
Owaisi,
is right
you,
and wrong.
You claim to be the leader of a party that represents the interests of not just Muslims but Dalit, backward castes, and other minorities and all underprivileged communities. Mr. Owaisi, what you have said is nothing short of an insult to those you claim to represent, because they too are born in a different religion, and yet you claim one religion superiority over others. Do you realize? Do you realize? Will you apologize, Mr. Owaisi, for what you've done?
We respect religion.
We
have to respect religion.
I think
a nation which respects religion,
which
allows cultures to practice their faith, to propagate their faith.
So
you don't want to accept it.
You have validated claims that you are a communal party, a religion-based party, and that you are no different from the Sangh Parivar affiliates who call India
a
Hindu
nation. It is your wrong statement.
It's not. Your comments prove you to be one.
I condemn your statement.
You can condemn me as much as you want, Mr. Owaisi.
This shows that Mr. Goswami has no pointed question to ask,
Mr.
apart
Owaisi,
from only reiterating
you,
from since
you know,
the program started, communal.
Now you are really beginning
please don't
to,
do it.
Now,
you
Mr.
don't
Owaisi.
Have,
Mr.
you're
Owaisi.
Not running an intellectual notary office to give someone a communal or secular certificate.
I'm not trying to give you. I'm
the
not trying to
India
give you. I'm not trying to give you. I have just, I have, what I have done, Mr. Owaisi, is point by point, question by question.
I
have proven your hypocrisy. And I have proven your political opportunism.
I have clearly answered all the questions that has been posed
Sudhanshu
to me,
Trivedi and
Gaurav Bhatia, people will watch this program, they will decide.
Well, the people who are watching the program will ask you one question. The people who are watching the program will ask you one question, Mr. Owaisi. And you know what that question is, Mr. Owaisi? You know what that question is. You know what that question is, Mr. Owaisi. You know what that question is. You know what that question is. The people watching the program will ask you, how have you suddenly woken up to this claim? The people who are watching the program will ask you, every child is not born a Muslim. Every child is not born a Muslim.
Which is part of
every child is not born a Muslim, Mr. Owaisi. Every child is not born a Hindu, a Christian, a Jew, or a Parsi.
We are saying there is no compulsion in religion.
And Mr. Owaisi, people watching the program will ask
you. You have all the right to practice.
We'll ask you just one question. And to answer that question, you will have to listen to your conscience, and they will ask you, Mr. Owaisi, are you so politically desperate today?
Listen to my view then.
And listen to the views of several other people. Why are you so intolerant? I'll tell you the question that you will have to ask your conscience today the next time you walk into parliament. Search your soul and ask your conscience whether you will sleep knowing that the only way for you to remain politically relevant.
No, there is one more fundamental question which is yet to be answered.
The only question is, Mr. Owaisi, when you walk into that parliament, ask yourself.
Keep on working.
Now you don't want to listen again.
So long as the people of India vote for me, and I don't need for you to remind me of my constitutional duty.
Mr. Owaisi,
I will.
I'll just complete my statement, and then I'll let others respond to you, please.
And I'll celebrate India's parliamentary democracy.
Gaurav and Sudhanshu will respond to you, but you know what? If the only way for you to remain politically irrelevant is to undermine other faiths and polarize this country a little bit more, you ought to be ashamed of yourself.
No, I am not undermining anyone.
Sudhanshu Trivedi is responding. Gaurav Bhatia is responding. I let them into the debate.
I am saying all faiths are equal.
I let them into the debate. Sudhanshu Trivedi, okay, Gaurav Bhatia first. Listen to others. Be a Democrat, for at least. At least be a Democrat. If if not a person who is truly secular, at least be a Democrat. Mr. Owaisi, 1 minute. 1 minute. Gaurav Bhatia is responding to you and Sudhanshu Trivedi.
I have to go.
No. Just listen to the other side.
Public meeting time.
Listen to the other side for a minute before you go. Gaurav Bhatia.
Please. Mr. Owaisi has to end.
For sure has heard the sentiments of every person who practices.
Please allow me to go.
30 seconds.
Sikhism. And I think for a member of parliament, the standard should be such. He should be so secular that persons from other religions...
Okay, Sudhanshu Trivedi, last word. Sudhanshu Trivedi. Sudhanshu Trivedi, please.
That please.
After this, we'll wrap up. Sudhanshu Trivedi. Sudhanshu Trivedi, please. Very quickly. Sudhanshu Trivedi.
Is completely not...
Let Sudhanshu Trivedi also come in, please.
One final question which is yet to be answered is, what was the final outcome of this type of divisive politics? If you go by the Satchar Committee recommendation and Ranganath Committee recommendation, the plight of Muslims... which has come to today's world.
Give us reservation.
Is responsibility of whom? The BJP which ruled for 6 years or the secular party so called ruled for 61 years. This type of divisive politics has given Muslims nothing.
Give Dalit status to Muslims. Are you ready for that?
Position of Muslims is better in BJP ruled state.
Are you ready for Dalit status to be given to Muslims?
Rather than the party ruled by this type of political parties.
Are
you ready for that?
We expect the answer from the Muslim community.
You talk about Satchar Committee.
And finally, sir,
I would like to say
why is it that your party in Maharashtra
for Mr. Asaduddin Owaisi?
Mr.
Why are you denying it?
Mr. Owaisi, ask yourself today if you are on the right path. There must be many other forms of doing politics.
I would like to say,
and if the viewers believe that Asaduddin Owaisi should apologize or take his words back, you can tell us what you think using the hashtag.
I will not apologize. This is part of my faith.
Well, you ought to, Mr. Owaisi. You ought to, Mr. Owaisi, and you ought to ask your conscience more than anything else. Thank you for joining me on this debate.
You don't need to remind me about my conscience.
On the news hour tonight. Thank you very much.